with special guests Aisha Tyler, Tony Hawk, and Anna Nicole Smith. Musical performances by Phantom Planet and Jadakiss, and exclusive looks at Splinter Cell Chaos Theory and Need for Speed Underground 2. It all starts next. G-Phoria, presented by EB Games and Jeep.
Presented by EB Games and Jeep, hosted by Carmen Electra and Dave Navarro, with appearances by Ant, Jillian Barberie, Kal Penn and John Cho, Racheal Harris, Tony Hawk, Jenna Jameson, members of Good Charolette, Just Blaze, Kennedy, Preston Lacy, Stan Lee, Bai Ling, Chad Muska, Mekhi Phifer, Ryan Pinkston, Anna Nicole Smith, Snoop Dogg, Hal Sparks, Aisha Tyler, Wee Man, Nikki Ziering, with performances by Chronic Future, Jadakiss, Mobius A, and Phantom Planet.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your hosts, Dave Navarro and Carmen Electra.
This year.
Yeah, there were some great video games out there, and we got a great show.
Yeah, we do.
Oh, yeah.
It's gonna be
Hold on. I got this covered, Jerry.
Who's this guy?
What's going on? We're just trying to host a show here.
Yeah, well, not so fast. Listen, after the blooper bowl boob flop incident, every award show now needs an FCC liaison.
Like that kind of coming?
I've seen your guys' show, and you have doo-doo mouths.
We've been a little crazy in our past, but we're very responsible. We won't do anything to cause any controversy.
I really appreciate that. I'm telling you, a lot of people in this business are real Have a good night.
Great. Okay. Figures, right?
Well, you know what? We've got a really great show tonight.
That is true. You bet we do. Cursing or not. You know what, babe? I say FCC, the FCC, right?
Yeah. So tonight, G-Phoria is packed with hot celebrities, cool performances, exciting video game exclusives, and some very big surprises. And I'm not talking about the Dave Navarro curse, if you know what I mean.
I'll tell you, babe, 2004 has been a great year for video games. Let's check this out, shall we?
Yes!
Oh, no!
Feels good.
I knew this day would come.
It begins.
Yeah. Thank you. All right. What? Them worry?
From Mad TV, please welcome
Ike Barinholtz,
Bobby Lee, and Ari Spears.
Oh, yeah, people. Boy!
Hi. We're here to present the EB Gamers Choice Award.
Voting for this award took place at ebgames.com and EB Games stores across the country.
Take a look at the nominees.
EB Gamers Choice Award. Need for Speed Underground. Duty. Wars, Knights of the Old Republic. Ninja Gaiden. Mario Kart, Double Dash.
The winner is Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic.
Yes. Celebratory statement. Hooray! HK-47 is the winner. Droids prove superior over the inferior meatbags.
What?
Give it up for HK-47.
No. Don't clap for that guy. He's an ass face.
Whatever, meatbag. I should have been named AK-47 because of the way I be spraying you meatbags.
Hey, man, what's your problem?
Hey, how come you ain't human so much?
Calculating answer. You guys suck.
That's it! I'm gonna kick your ass! You're getting too dead!
Peace. I'm out.
You hate robots!
What's going on? Welcome to the Skybox at G-Phoria. I'm Cliffy B.
That's right, and I'm Tina Wood. Now, throughout the show, we're going to be bringing you a first-person perspective of all the action. Cliff, what's up with HK-47? Serious baggage, dude.
Seriously, I think that robot needs some serious anger management.
That's right, but in any case, his game, Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic, is up for Game of the Year.
Tina, you know, I got to tell you, as a game designer, I'm so psyched to check out all the exclusives we have of all the hottest unreleased games.
Absolutely. So let's get right to the action with the first exclusive of the night, Def Jam Fight for New York.
It's showtime. You see that, right?
Are you getting the message?
Next, man, I'm just getting started.
Coming up, some guys in red and blue armor. But before we go, let's take a look at our first nominee for Game of the Year. It's Beautiful Joe.
Joe's the main character. He's like a teenager.
He's an everyday guy.
He's watching a movie with his girlfriend, and then a monster pops up.
Yeah, she gets sucked into the movie.
Then he turns into Beautiful Joe.
Gotta rescue your lady.
Hey, am I inside the movie?
Correct, my young friend.
Time to go to work, guys.
My hero.
From Sky Captain and the World of Tomorrow, please welcome Bai Ling.
Good evening. I'm so happy to be here this evening. It's such a wonderful show with all the video games, beautiful people, and live music. And I'm very happy to be introducing this next band because they kick so much ass. You need two pairs of pants on just to listen to them. So, G-Phoria, here they come. Please welcome Phantom Planet.
It was all his fault. Introduced me to know it all and the cannibal. By the time they started showing up, I ran the risk of blowing up. These times get tough. So if I stay, we're gonna see who's had enough. So by the time I need him backing up, yeah, he was watching, cracking up. This time it's tough. But here I am, and now I think I've had enough. Stand back. Take that and that. slew of masses, I know there is no escape. Only flail and arms and bellies. And when it all started coming down tonight, what to one and all? I guess that we all make mistakes. I know I forgave you, didn't I? Such a big brat, yeah, you're always up to no good. Yeah, you're always up to no good. Oh, yeah, you're always up to no good. Yeah, you're always up to no good.
Nicole Smith.
Hottest character.
Later, Jenna Jameson.
Game of the year.
Jadakiss. As G-Phoria, presented by EB Games and Jeep, continues.
The trail-rated Jeep Liberty. With its Command Track four-wheel drive and dynamic suspension system, it'll get you out of the most impossible situations. Capability only in a Jeep 4x4.
So I go to Singular for a prepaid phone, and the sales guy hands me this phone with a color screen. And I was like, get out. And he says, yeah, and I can get the latest ringtones and games. And I was like, get out. Then he threw in unlimited weekend minutes, and I was like, get out, get out, get out. And then I got out of there before he changed his mind.
Singular announces a new way to pay as you go. Get features you want, great phone deals, and unlimited weekend calling.
I call it my this phone is loaded plan.
Cool phones on prepaid, another reason Singular fits you best.
Out of the ordinary into a crispity, crunchy, peanut buttery Butterfinger from Nestle.
Why should you consider getting an education in the Navy? This is one of your classrooms. Navy, accelerate your life.
Whether you're playing for bragging rights or making a run at 50 grand in Vegas, prepare for the hardest-hitting video game tournament in America with the 2004 EA Sports Madden Challenge Kickoff Show with tips from Madden experts.
Pick the team that's right for you.
If you catch the person at the right time, that could be a real punishing shot.
Advice from tournament veterans.
You gotta keep everybody off balance.
And a look at the kings of the controller.
I'm gonna shock some people tonight.
The 2004 EA Sports Madden Challenge Kickoff Show. Tune in Monday at 10:30 p.m.
Changing.
Yeah, just putting a little something else on.
You weren't doing anything weird?
Honey, I told you those days are long gone. I don't do that anymore.
Okay, honey, I didn't want to have to do this.
What?
Can we roll the security tape, please?
No, honey, no.
Stormtroopers did you kill?
Very funny, very funny. Like 100.
Okay, our next presenter has done it all, and she's hot, seriously.
Please welcome one of the hottest women on the planet, Anna Nicole Smith.
Woo! For the award for hottest character. So I pulled some strings and assembled the top five models in the world to pay tribute to the hottest characters in video games. Enjoy!
Hottest character. Ivy, Soul Calibur 2. Vanessa Schneider, Piano 3. Riku, Final Fantasy X-2. Pharah, Prince of Persia, The Sands of Time.
Caution, caution.
Stacy Keebler, WWE SmackDown. Here comes the pain.
Thanks, girls. Looking good. And the award for hottest character goes to... Riku!
Sorry I couldn't be there tonight, but I want to thank everyone for thinking I'm so hot. It really means a lot to hear it from other people, because if I said it myself, I would just sound like I was bragging. So thanks, G-Phoria.
Hottest.
Dude, what's so funny?
Nothing, Mr. Navarro, sir. Just getting back to work.
Is something funny in there? Come on, let me check it out.
I don't know.
I'll trade files with you. I got this great night vision thing. You'll love it, I promise. Let me check it out. Could use a laugh.
Okay.
I like funny stuff too, you know.
Okay.
What is this? Well, that's not funny.
Well, actually, it was downloaded on the net by a fan.
The net?
There's like 100 versions already.
100 of these? Carmen!
I think you're hot.
Yeah, Carmen!
Oh, man, I got 3 words for you. That was awesome.
Seriously. To be honest, though, Tina, I would have thought the first video of Dave leaked on the internet probably would have been a raunchy sex tape or something like that.
Yeah, but Cliff, you act like everyone's got a raunchy sex tape on them.
Kind of thought they did by now. Seriously, though, you know what I think is going to be really hot? Carmen Electra and her bunny friends in the upcoming Playboy the Mansion game. Right, ladies?
Oh, now a lot of people have been waiting for Playboy to finally do a game, like every guy on the planet. But here's a Game of the Year nominee where they actually keep their clothes on. It's Prince of Persia, the Sands of Time.
You're basically this magical prince who unleashes the sands of time.
It kills everyone except whoever has the dagger.
Give me the dagger. Give it to me.
No, don't!
Did you really think you could defeat me?
It will happen.
Please welcome motocross and BMX daredevils, Carrie Hart and Alan Cook.
You know, there used to be a time when alternative sports athletes were referred to as troublemakers.
But now they got another name for us.
Yeah, Rich.
Are you rich? Here are the nominees for Alt Sports Award powered by Mountain Dew.
Alt Sports Award powered by Mountain Dew. Tony Hawk's Underground. NBA Street Volume 2. NFL Street. SSX 3. WWE SmackDown. Here comes the pain.
And the winner is Tony Hawk Underground.
Ladies and gentlemen, Tony Hawk.
We're here to talk about the man who dumbed down the dumbest sport of all time, Tony Hawk. That's right. Hey, and how about Tony's video game? Huh? That thing sold 500,000 units in the first week. The only thing to sell out faster than that is Tony Hawk. Yeah. Nick and Jessica have more street cred than you, man. Paris Hilton calls you a whore, Tony. Congratulations on your award, buddy.
I have to confess, I'm really only here because I was told Halo 2 would be in the gift bag. P.S., it isn't. But of course, Tony, you've retired from competitive skateboarding, which is kind of like a hobo retiring from riding trains. You know, Michael Jordan retired too. The only difference is people actually cared. Now, Tony, here is something special on your big day. Are you ready for something sexy?
Yes, absolutely.
Something a little lacy?
Yes, please.
How about a little Preston Lacy? Hit it!
Ooh,
That was disturbing. But seriously, folks, I was talking to Anna Nicole Smith about stem cell. What?
Yo, Tony, what's up with that hair anyway, man? You haven't had a haircut in like 30 years, dude!
Hey, this guy is so old, you should be sponsored by Depends. Hey, Chad and I are here to represent Thug 2 and also to introduce a badass teammate of mine, Paulie.
That's right.
Oh, yeah! Paulie Wheels of Fury Ryan! What's in your ass? Seriously, though, Tony, Allie McNeil called, and she wants her upper body back. When they call you the Birdman, what kind of bird are they talking about? This one?
Like the t-shirt says, skateboarding is not a crime. So kids, go out tonight and shoplift a copy of this man's video game, The Man of the Hour. Let's get him up here.
I want to thank all of you for playing our games. Mostly thank Neversoft for designing it and also Activision for publishing it, but mostly to the fans of the games. Thank you. I'm not sure if this was an honor, but thanks for having it anyway.
Oh, butt nuggets?
Bring it on, bitch!
Next, Jenna Jameson, Jadakiss, Best Racing Game, later Kal Penn and John Cho. G-Phoria, presented by ED Games and Jeep, continues.
Oh, thanks, Marge.
Sorry.
There's this guy named Murphy. He's got this law that says whatever can go wrong will. That's why the trail-rated Jeep Grand Cherokee is tested on Earth's toughest terrain. It's your loophole in Murphy's Law.
Mike, stop!
Trail-rated capability. Only in a Jeep 4x4.
Champ Sports, where sport lives.
Yeah.
Razor's having a huge back-to-school sale on camera phones. We're all getting Motorola's with Bluetooth technology.
The Samsung with Zoom.
Wait, I thought we agreed on the LG. No. It downloads games.
It's Zoom.
You know what, guys? We don't always have to do everything alike.
Celebrate back to school with up to $150 off a super wide selection of the coolest new camera phones available.
We call it our Now You Can Tell Us Apart plan.
Great savings on camera phones. Another reason Singular fits you best.
What are your dreams? Do they include playing video games? Or making video games? Or both? Stop dreaming. Pick up the phone, call Collins College, and start a career doing what you love in the new game design program. Call 1-888-256-1200 now. That's 1-888-256-1200.
You ever think you might have worms? If your computer is slowing down or crashing or just acting weird,
e-acceleration with the full power of Stop Sign can make it like new again.
Stop Sign gives you virus protection second to none.
With a spam blocker and spyware remover,
pop-up blocker,
and the Stop Sign firewall for all the protection you'll ever need.
Guaranteed.
You may be infected and not even know it. Go to stopsign.com for a free virus scan now.
Weeknights, late night, hold on tight.
Get a load of this.
At 11, go crazy with Video Game Mania on X-Play.
The biggest video game event in the world.
Then take a walk on the wild side of technology on Unscrewed with Martin Sargent.
I'm Martin Sargent, and I like to ramble.
That was fantastic.
It's back-to-back action. Weeknights, X-Play at 11, and Unscrewed at 11:30, only on G4 Tech TV.
For the next 17 weeks, I'll be bringing you the hottest in Madden action.
The 2004 EA Sports Madden Challenge Kickoff Show, Monday, August 9th at 10:30 p.m.
Right? Chances are our next presenter's films are hidden somewhere in your house. Mm-hmm.
Or in our case, displayed on the mantelpiece. Please put your hands together and welcome the lovely, the fabulous, and the very talented.
And the sexy.
And the sexy. Jenna Jameson, people. Woo!
Yeah. You know, I've played a lot of heart-racing, chest-pounding games this year, and some of the video games were pretty hot, too. Check out the nominees for Best Racing Game.
Best Racing Game. F-Zero GX. Project Gotham Racing 2. Need for Speed Underground.
Cold rockin' it.
Mario Kart Double Dash. Midnight Club 2.
And the winner is... I've got the need. The Need for Speed. Do you want to see something really hot? Something I have never shown you before. You know, I want to show it to you, but I don't know if you can handle it. Okay, guys. Obviously, that guy's, like, really ready for it. Alrighty, then. Here it is, an exclusive look at the new Need for Speed Underground 2.
I'm gonna have to go with Jenna. Stick around, guys. We got lots more game exclusives to show you coming up.
That's right, but first, it's time to answer the Call of Duty, our next Game of the Year nominee.
It's about World War II.
Everywhere from Normandy Beach to inside Germany. The sergeant will order you to
take out artillery, cross enemy lines, infiltrate like different cities.
If you don't do your part, your whole squad could die.
Third squad, let's go, go, go! Take cover, this cannon's about to go boom! Squad, move up! Go, go, go!
Please welcome acclaimed record producer, Just Blaze.
Our next performer is a master of all words. He's also a master of all vowels, like A, E, I, O, and U. Right now, most importantly, is Y. Straight from Yonkers, New York, ladies and gentlemen, please make some noise for my man, Jadakiss.
Yeah, real. Yo, why is Jada as hard as it gets? Hard as it gets. Why is the industry designed to keep the artists dead? And why them dudes ain't riding if they party a set? And why they never get it popping but they party to death? Yeah, and why they gon' give you life for murder? Turn around, only give you 8 months for murder. It's going down, why they selling people CDs for under? And if it's all love, daddy, why you come with your nines? Why my homies ain't get that? Why is a brother up north better than Jordan? Ain't get that break? Why you ain't stacking instead of trying to be fly? Why is ratting at an all-time high? Why are you even alive? Why they kill Tupac and Chris? Why at the bar you don't take straight shots instead of popping Chris? Why them bullets have to hit that door? Why did Kobe have to hit that raw? And why he kiss that broad? Why? Hands in the air, side to side, y'all. 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 Hey, yo. Side to side, y'all. 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 Yeah, yeah, yo. Why do people push pounds and powder? Why did Bush knock down the tower? Why you around them cowards? Why Leah have to take that flight? Why my homie D ain't pull out his Ferrari? Why he take that bike? Why they gotta open your package and read your mail? Why they stop letting brothers get the grease in jail? Why you gotta do 85% of your time? And why the rappers line 85% of their time? Why brother always want what he can't have? And why I can't come through in the pecan? Why they crack have to hit so hard, even though it's almost over? Then why we can't get no job? Why they come up with the witness protection? Why they let the Terminator win the election? Come on, pay attention. Why sell in the store what you been selling the streets? And why I say the hottest shit but we selling the least? Yeah, side to side, y'all. 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 Yeah, hey, yo. Side to side, y'all. Side to side, y'all. Side to side, y'all. Kiss his ass.
Side to side, y'all.
Yeah.
Tell me what's up, son.
Yeah. Yo. Why do they have to let a gray man pop her to get her? And why Denzel had to be crooked before he
took it?
Why they didn't make the CL6 with a clutch? And if you don't smoke, then why the hell you reaching for my Dutch? Why rap? Cause I need airtime. Why be on the curb with a wild lie? I need a beer. Why all the young brothers is dying? Cause they moms at work, they pops is gone, they living with iron. Why they ain't giving secure for
days?
Why my diesel had fiends in a spot on the floor for
days?
Why you screaming like it's a slug, it's only the hall? Why my buzz in LA ain't like it is in New York? Why they forcing you to be hard? Why ain't you a thug by choice? Why the whole world love my, yeah, I try to tell them that it's the flow, son. You know why they made the new 20s,
I got all the old ones.
Side to side, y'all. 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 Yeah, hey, yo, why they gotta do us like? Side to side, y'all. 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 Yeah, listen. Kiss it down.
Yeah.
Don't be
afraid to ask.
just bail, come on,
just bail,
come on,
just bail,
come on,
just bail,
come on,
just bail,
come on,
just bail.
Vote, y'all.
Next, members of Good Charolette, later Snoop Dogg. SG4ia, presented by EB Games and Jeep, continues.
The legend grows. The new, longer Jeep Wrangler Unlimited, with more legroom, twice the cargo space, and trail-rated capability. Only in a Jeep 4x4.
What's a camping trip without beer?
Well, it's still a camping trip, actually, just with less vomiting.
This summer...
Pretty thick country up there.
Hey, look, a deer!
You're invited to experience the sights.
Cue the insane hillbillies.
How you like me now, boy?
The sounds.
Don't let them smell your fear.
Help me!
And the beauty.
All cleaner.
I'm all natural.
Of the great outdoors. Without a paddle.
I love camping.
Rated PG-13. Starts Wednesday, August 18th.
Your reign ends right here.
Yeah, tear it up.
Dang!
Oh, see, that's what I'm talking about. Come here, let me show you something. You like the heat? You feeling them?
Yeah.
Go give me a pair.
The rookie is back. Check out the shoes. The hat's the match. The shirt. It's all good.
Hey, rookie. Where are my shoes? Get the Reebok Classic Clip Groove. Only at Champ Sports, where sport lives.
Come on, guys.
Can I trade in Tube Slider and get store credit for Mario Sunshine?
You want to trade an old game for a new one?
Electronic stores don't take games seriously. You gotta talk to gamers.
Yeah, anytime you get tired of a game, trade it in for store credit. You're gonna love Mario Sunshine.
Nice. For your nearest store, visit ebgames.com. Pre-owned games and equipment at big discounts. If you're serious about games, talk to the gamers at EB Games.
Singular is having a huge back-to-school sale on camera phones. We're all getting Motorola's with Bluetooth technology. The Samsung with Zoom. Wait, I thought we agreed on the LG. No. It downloads games.
The Zoom.
You know what, guys? We don't always have to do everything alike.
Celebrate back to school with up to $150 off a super wide selection of the coolest new camera phones available.
We call it our Now You Can Tell Us Apart plan.
Great savings on camera phones. Another reason Singular fits you best.
Playing for bragging rights or making a run at 50 grand in Vegas. Prepare for the hardest hitting video game tournament in America with the 2004 EA Sports Madden Challenge Kickoff Show. With tips from Madden experts.
Pick the team that's right for you.
If you catch the person at the right time, that could be a real punishing shot.
Advice from tournament veterans.
You gotta keep everybody off balance.
And a look at the kings of the controller.
I'm gonna shock some people tonight.
The 2004 EA Sports Madden Challenge Kickoff Show. Tune in Monday at 10:30 p.m.
Gentlemen, please help us welcome a very special guest, a man who knows a thing or two about creating fantasy worlds.
He's one of the most innovative comic book creators of all time and the father of the Marvel Universe. Give it up for Stan the Man Lee!
Revolver Ocelot has arrived. Tonight, we honor the creators of the fantastic Metal Gear franchise, Hideo Kojima!
Legend Award, presented by Jeep. Hideo Kojima redefined the world of action gaming with the Metal Gear Solid series. Through his painstaking research into the world of international espionage, to the multitude of characters who populate his worlds, to his creation of a hero whose silent stalking took all of us hostage. In 1988, Solid Snake explodes onto the scene in the first Metal Gear for the NES. The detailed world instantly establishes Hideo Kojima as a certified video game visionary. And then, what a difference 10 years made. 1998's Metal Gear Solid was the cinematic video game experience. Kojima exploited the 3D camera in ways never imagined, focusing the action on stealth rather than traditional run-and-gun gameplay. 3 years later, a new era in storytelling was born as Snake returned in Metal Gear Solid 2, Sons of Liberty. Through next-gen graphics, astounding gameplay, and a twisting storyline, Hideo Kojima re-envisioned what we think of as interactive entertainment. But for his next masterpiece, he needed to go back in time and in technology, undergoing real-life survival training in the jungles of Asia, returning Snake to his natural environment. With Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater set for release later this year, Kojima's legendary game and his hero lives on.
It is my great pleasure to introduce a creator, an innovator, and an awesome dude. Ladies and gentlemen, the recipient of the Legend Award presented by Jeep, Hideo Kojima!
Hi everyone. I am Hideo Kojima. It is a great honor to receive the Legend Award. My dream as a child was to go to space. My dream as a teenager was to shoot films. As a young man, I have encountered games. Since then, I have been creating games for 18 years. I have turned 40 this past year. My dream right now, it's keep on creating games until I die. That is why I am very happy to receive this award. Thank you. Thank you very much.
As a token of Mr. Kojima's gratitude for this award, he's brought something very special to G-Phoria.
And here it is, a never-before-seen sneak peek at his latest creation, Metal Gear Solid number 3, Snake Eater!
appearance in MGS 3?
I sure hope so, Tina. Now, you didn't hear this from me, okay? You didn't?
All right.
But there may be a parody of I Love the 80s coming up.
All right, right, Cliff, but I did just hear it from you. Spoiler.
Sorry.
Anyway, we saw Prince of Persia earlier, which was built off the engine originally developed for this Game of the Year nominee, Beyond Good and Evil.
It's a sci-fi adventure. Jade, the main character,
is trying to uncover a government conspiracy.
Whatever you do, don't get caught.
She gets help from Paige, half pig, half human.
We're in the middle of a war, son. Everyone is already dead. We've sucked them dry. Your days are numbered.
From Good Charolette, Joel Madden and Billy Martin.
Yeah. Billy Blood.
Yeah. Traveling around on the road all the time, being on tour, we get a lot of time to play video games, and we spend most of our time playing video games.
Sometimes we play so many video games that we begin to lose track of what's a game and what's reality.
Yeah, like for example, on the way over here, I carjacked an Escalade and gunned down an old lady.
And I sort of feel like I'm in outer space giving a speech to a bunch of space wizards with cool pointy hats.
What game's that?
I don't know, dude. I think I lost it.
I think my game is better. All right, anyways, these are the nominees for Best Traditional Sports Game.
Best Traditional Sports Game. Tiger Woods, PGA Tour 2004. World Soccer winning 11-7. Madden NFL 2004. Top Spin. ESPN, NBA Basketball.
All right, let's give it to him.
All right, the winner is Madden 2004.
Accepting the award for Madden Football is Assistant Encoder of Programming, Ned Gray.
Hey, everybody. Wow, that's a lot of people. My name is Ned Gray, and I was the assistant encoder of programming for Madden 2004. Thank you. Thank you, guys.
Good job, buddy!
Thank you very much. I know you don't think about me very much, but you couldn't play the game without me, so... Hey! Who threw that? Ow! Oh, God! Stop! Please! I'm not even the lead encoder! Please.
Other awards presented this evening. Best Adaptation, Star Wars, Knights of the Old Republic. Best Innovation, Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell, Pandora Tomorrow Multiplayer. Best Mobile Phone Game, Bejeweled Multiplayer. Best Voice Performance Male, Pierce Brosnan.
Bond. James Bond.
007, Everything or Nothing. Best Multiplayer Game, Unreal Tournament 2004. Best Sound Design, The Lord of the Rings, The Return of the King. Next, Kal Penn and John Cho, Aisha Tyler, Best Easter Egg. Later, Chronic Future, Mekhi Phifer. As G-Phoria, presented by EB Games and Jeep, continues.
Hey, Dad, this computer would be perfect for school.
Yeah, but this one would be a lot easier for you to, you know, bring home every weekend.
It's that time again. And Circuit City's the place for all your new school gear. Come on and save $250 on this HP notebook computer with an AMD Athlon XPM processor and built-in wireless G capability. Just $849.99 after mail-in rebates and instant savings. Right now at Circuit City.
Hi, I'm Karen from Infrastructure DB, and here's Winterfuel on the Winterfresh Network. Oh, yes!
unhand my Winterfresh gum.
The Winterfresh gum is rightfully mine.
Ha 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 ha. Oh, yes! Oh, yes!
Winterfresh Network, where icy cool breath is always on.
Only at Champ Sports, where sport lives.
So I go to Singular for a prepaid phone, and the sales guy hands me this phone with a color screen. And I was like, get out. And he says, yeah, and I can get the latest ringtones and games. And I was like, get out. Then he threw in unlimited weekend minutes, and I was like, get out, get out, get out! And then I got out of there before he changed his mind.
Singular announces a new way to pay as you go. Get features you want, great phone deals, and unlimited weekend calling.
I call it my, this phone is loaded. Plan.
Cool phones on prepaid. Another reason Singular fits you best.
If someone wrote a book about your life, would anyone want to read it? The stories of tomorrow are being written today in the U.S. Navy. You'll do more in a few years than most people do in a lifetime. If you're ready, check out the Life Accelerator at Navy.com. Navy, accelerate your life.
You ugly son of a...
We're in the middle of a war.
Alien vs. Predator, rated PG-13, August 13th.
Check this out. This is what we do for a living.
We're video game designers.
And we're game programmers.
With the training offered at Collins College, you can learn to design, code, and test games like this.
And this.
Game design is a growing career.
For a brochure on a career in game design, call Collins College at 1-888-256-1200 now. That's 1-888-256-1200. Call Collins College now.
Why does the U.S. Olympic team compete with the support of thousands of Gateway PCs? Because serious competitors require serious power. Right now, Gateway can equip you to compete with free double memory, a free processor upgrade, and free shipping on our 310T power package, all for just $499.99. You'll get a fast Intel Pentium 4 processor, a big 17-inch monitor, extra memory, and gold medal service and support. Plus, free shipping if you order now. Call 1-800-GATEWAY today.
Hey, what's up? I'm Dave Navarro.
And I'm Carmen Electra, and we're going to be your hosts this year at G-Phoria.
G-Phoria, the award show for gamers, with special guests Aisha Tyler, Tony Hawk, and Anna Nicole Smith. Musical performances by Phantom Planet and Jadakiss, and exclusive looks at Splinter Cell Chaos Theory and Need for Speed Underground 2. G-Phoria, presented by EB Games and Jeep, tonight at 10:30.
For the next 17 weeks, I'll be bringing you the hottest in Madden action.
The 2004 EA Sports Madden Challenge Kickoff Show, Monday, August 9th at 10:30 p.m.
Dance, dance, revolution!
Go to White Castle, John Cho, and Kal Penn.
Hey, Cal, what's going on there? You excited about the show?
Oh, dude, yeah, I'm a big gamer. Really excited to be here.
Yeah. Yeah, I can see that.
Anyway, we are here to present the award for Best New Franchise.
Uh-huh, that's true. You know, Cal, another way of saying franchise is tentpole.
That's great. Dude, why don't we just be professional and stick to the teleprompter? Is that right?
Dude!
Dude, I know. Well, I told you, I'm really excited to be here.
All right. Here are the nominees for Best New Franchise.
Best New Franchise. Far Cry. Beyond Good and Evil. Ready, action. Beautiful Joe.
Time to do the wood.
Call of Duty. Breakdown.
Do you copy?
Wake up.
And the winner is
Beautiful Joe.
The action. The attitude.
Oh man, don't flatter yourself.
The spandex.
What's up? We'll come and get.
It's 2004, and this is I Love Beautiful Joe.
Joe is just this, you know, cool dude who just wants to see his favorite old movie, Captain Blue.
But his lady friend wants some different action.
Honey, why don't you show me some off-screen action?
If you listen carefully, you can hear a zipper. Listen. Yeah.
Of course she wants him. The guy looks like Ricky Schroeder. Gorgeous!
Yeah, but he's so not interested in her.
I said cut it out. They don't show these old movies all the time, you know.
What is with her? She's throwing herself at him like a $2 hooer.
Cut it out.
And what is with him? She's throwing herself at him like a $2 hooer.
Yeah, the problem, I think, is her ginormous birth control glasses.
That girl looks familiar, though.
What?
Got the letters HMD on his shirt, which of course stands for Huge Man Dingo.
It's actually for Huge Motor Dykes. He was the bitch of a lesbian biker gang.
Yeah, actually it means his master's dance. At least that's what my nerdy friend Ken told me.
Always go wrong once before you get to the happy ending.
If all he wanted was a happy ending, he should have just gone to a massage parlor.
I should cut it out.
Then the sex machine arrives.
It's sex machine.
The girl is mine!
And transports Joe into the movie so he can save Sylvia. Kind of like Last Action Hero, only not as sucky or governmental.
Hooray, the bitch is gone. Time to put on spandex.
Cool. A real V-Watch.
He's a little whiny for a hero.
I got rid of my girlfriend, but I traded her for a cool watch.
What is a beautiful anyway?
I think if you unlock 50 beautifuls, you get to see the Paris Hilton sex tape.
I love Beautiful Joe because it's a great innovative game and he trades in the girl for tights and a cape.
I love Beautiful Joe because he has awesome taste in the ladies. Sylvia's hot.
I love Beautiful Joe because it's not the 80s or the 90s.
I love Beautiful Joe because they wouldn't let me in the spit unless I said I did.
Loves Beautiful Joe.
Tina, yeah.
You know what I love?
What?
Do you know?
Who?
Do you know what?
What?
Night vision goggles.
Ooh, do you know who I love?
Who?
What?
Who?
When?
Tell me.
Sam Fisher.
Aww.
Hey, let's take an exclusive look at a new level of Splinter Cell 3 due out later this year.
Thank you.
say Mobius 8.
I don't get it.
You'll find out after the Game of the Year is revealed later on.
And speaking of the Game of the Year, it could be Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic, our next nominee.
You get to choose whether you're going to be a light or dark Jedi.
You can be
the hero,
evil bastard, male or female,
black or white.
You choose the head.
I'm kind of bald right now, so my character's bald.
I picked to be a black guy, because there wasn't too many brothers to pick.
Did I say that out loud?
You are growing weary. I can sense it.
The lure of the dark side is difficult to resist.
Hurry up and grab your gear. For the Republic!
Revan has returned.
You are stronger than I thought.
Darth Malak.
You cannot beat me, Revan.
The fate of the galaxy is in your hands.
Please welcome a gamer as funny as she is beautiful, Aisha Tyler.
I remember the weirdest place that I ever found an Easter egg was in my brother's underwear drawer. And which was even weirder about it was that it was the 4th of July, and I don't have a brother. But I love Tidy Whities. Oh. Anyway, and that reminds me, I gotta show you guys the nominees for the best Easter egg.
Best Easter egg. Unlock Snoop Dogg, True Crime, Streets of LA.
Let's rock and roll, baby. I got you. Let's do it. The D-O-double-G.
Geometry Wars, Project Gotham Racing 2. Unlock Star Wars Arcade, Star Wars Rogue Squadron 3, Rebel Strike. Yahoo! Unlock 3D Remake, Prince of Persia, The Sands of Time.
After him!
Insomniac Museum, Ratchet & Clank, Going Commando.
All right, and the winner is... it's funny, there's a walkthrough in here, and it says up, up, down, down, left, right, B-A-B-A, start. Unlock Snoop Dogg and True Crime, Streets of L.A.
G-Phoria. Oh, wait. Is the G enough for you? This is Big Snoop Dogg here coming at you live and direct. Thanking y'all for making me the best Easter egg on True Crime, Streets of L.A. I'm a crazy motherfucker. All I need now is a Playboy bunny. Where my bunnies at?
I got him right here, Snoop. I got right hizzle for shizzle, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, what's going on here?
Honey, I can explain.
Explain this.
Nikki Ziering, Jillian Barberie, and Ryan Pinkston. Chronic Future, later, Game of the Year. SG4ia, presented by EB Games and Jeep, continues.
The trail-rated Jeep Liberty, with its Command Track four-wheel drive and dynamic suspension system, it'll get you out of the most impossible situations. Trail-rated capability, only in a Jeep 4x4.
Your reign ends right here.
Yep, tear it up.
Dang!
Oh, see, that's what I'm talking about. Come here, let me show you something. You like this? You feeling them?
Yeah.
Go get me a pair.
The rookie is back. Check out the shoes. The hat's the match. The shirt, it's all good.
Hey, rookie, where are my shoes?
Get the Reebok Classic Clip Groove, only at Champ Sports, where sport lives.
Come on, guys.
So I go to Singular for a prepaid phone, and the sales guy hands me this phone with a color screen. And I was like, get out. And he says, yeah, and I can get the latest ringtones and games. And I was like, get out. Then he threw in unlimited weekend minutes, and I was like, get out, get out, get out. And then I got out of there before he changed his mind.
Singular announces a new way to pay as you go. Get features you want, great phone deals, and unlimited weekend calling.
I call it my this phone is loaded plan.
Cool phones on prepaid, another reason Singular fits you best.
Maybe I didn't treat you quite as good as I should have. If I made you feel second best, girl, I'm sorry I was blind, but you were always on my mind. You were always on my mind.
There is one card so powerful, so dangerous, so uncontrollable, it could even defeat Yugi. It was locked away forever. Until now.
Yugi, we've only got one chance left!
With a future at stake, the world turns to one person. Yu-Gi-Oh! The Movie. And when you see Yu-Gi-Oh! The Movie, you can receive one of four special Yu-Gi-Oh! Cards you can't get anywhere else. Yu-Gi-Oh! The Movie. Rated PG. The duel begins August 13th. Only in theaters.
Whether you're playing for bragging rights or making a run at 50 grand in Vegas, prepare for the hardest-hitting video game tournament in America with the 2004 EA Sports Madden Challenge Kickoff Show, with tips from Madden experts.
Pick the team that's right for you.
If you catch the person at the right time, that could be a real punishing shot.
Advice from tournament veterans.
You gotta keep everybody off balance.
And a look at the kings of the controller.
I'm gonna shock some people tonight.
The 2004 EA Sports Madden Challenge Kickoff Show. Tune in Monday at 10:30 p.m.
Please welcome, from National Lampoon's Gold Diggers, Nikki Ziering.
Video game cinematics have become an art form all their own, rivaling the best that Hollywood blockbusters have to offer. Take a look at some scenes that you would never want to skip through.
Best cinematic, The Lord of the Rings, The Return of the King. Dragon Guard.
It begins.
Final Fantasy 10-2. Ninja Gaiden. Metal Gear Solid, The Twin Snakes.
The winner is Final Fantasy X-2.
Game cinematics could actually get any cooler.
Now, Cliffy, whereas movie sequels tend to typically suck,
totally,
game sequels seem to get better.
Absolutely, Tina. And speaking of sequels, the master designers at Ubisoft are bringing you the sequel to one of their biggest games. We're the first to have a glimpse of Prince of Persia 2. I'm telling you, Tina, that could be a nominee for Game of the Year at next year's show.
Absolutely. Well, here is tonight's last nominee. It stars a furry alien and a robot that enjoy going commando.
You know, Tina, I'm going commando right now.
Yeah, me too. Take a look at Ratchet and Clank going commando.
Ratchet's got like big long ears, like about right around here.
He has a huge gun.
And Clank,
his little mechanical friend.
He can glide like a helicopter.
Megacorp lost his secret animal kind of thing.
It's like a Furby.
And they go to Ratchet and Clank.
The mission?
Find that genetic thing.
We'll do it!
Introducing the Megacorp Protopet.
Ratchet and Clank, I'm gonna blast you into so many pieces.
Proto
Kalpen mania is in full swing.
Finish him.
Draw your last enemy.
Let's get going.
Oh, no.
Please welcome Jillian Barberie and Ryan Pinkston.
You guys having a good time? So are we.
All right. Yeah, definitely. So anyways, this next band will do it for me time and time again.
I thought that was my job.
Yeah,
anyway,
that's what I thought too.
All right, put your hands together for Chronic Future.
Perfect in its splendor, like the currents of the weather. It's splintering my center, hindering all of my pleasure. Me manifesting that, doing this endeavor. The one's responsibility is taken at the render. Experience to me, however, I'm gonna remember.
Time and time again, we fall into the depths. And do we dive into death? Keep running away from what we're trying to find.
Put yourself through the experience of scenarios, enter experiences, normally within there to go, off with a character, an arrogant afterglow, knowing its appearance more than to your matter, up from what's your clearance, and an avenue to handle, make sure you're very gorgeous, when they're putting out your candles, predictions very unkind, unwind them still, don't erase the part of you that's misplaced, before you will.
Time and time again, we fall into the depths of who we are, but you can't keep running away from what you're trying to find. Time and time again, we fall into the depths of who we are, but you can't keep running away from what you're trying to find.
It's hard to feel swift. It's stuck in my stomach as I can't even make the lift. I've been pushing it down, pretending it doesn't exist. Well, this is what happens when you're pissed about being pissed. You think yourself so neat, you resist just to resist. And there's no way to get back experiences you miss. So start right now, today you miss. Give me a sense for bliss.
Time and time again, we fall into the depths of who we are, but you can't keep running away from what you're dying to find. Time and time again, we fall into the depths of who we are, but you can't keep running away from what you're dying to find. Time and time again, we fall into the depths of who we are.
Thank you.
Other awards presented this evening. Best soundtrack.
Music.
Tony Hawk's Underground. Best handheld game. Final Fantasy Tactics Advance. Best graphics. Ninja Gaiden. Best role-playing game. Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. Favorite character. Ryu Hayabusa. Ninja Gaiden. Best voice performance. Female.
We're in.
Jada Pinkett Smith. Enter the Matrix.
Get me out of here now!
Next, Mekhi Phifer, Game of the Year, as G-Phoria, presented by EB Games and Jeep, continues.
Break out of the ordinary into a crispity, crunchy, peanut buttery Butterfinger from Nestle.
Ma'am, is Final Fantasy in your used game section?
Used games? You really do like fantasy, don't you?
Toy stores don't take games seriously. You gotta talk to gamers.
Final Fantasy breaks the role-playing mold, and you can save some cash if you buy it pre-owned.
Cool. Pre-owned games and equipment at big discounts. Save on new games by trading in old ones. Try them before you buy them.
If you're serious about games, talk to the gamers at EB Games.
Make the cut. Only at Champ Sports, where sport lives.
Get a little closer. Eric keeps you dry. No odor, no shy, just dry.
Aerid is unsurpassed. It helps stop wetness so odor can't start.
Eric keeps you dry.
You know that buddy list you love? Now you can take it with you on your Singular phone. Because no one makes it easier to use mobile instant messaging than Singular. Your buddy list goes with you everywhere. And right now, get unlimited instant messaging for $2.99 and a great deal on I Am Ready Nokia phones.
I call it my buddy list goes with me plan.
AOL Instant Messenger, another reason Singular fits you best.
Are you ready to see the big show, folks? Ladies and gentlemen, behold, if you dare, witness the mind-bending curiosity of the radiation people. Exposed to polonium-210, a deadly radioactive isotope that's linked to causing cancer in humans. Ladies and gentlemen, behold the radiation people. One more thing you should know about polonium-210, it's also found in cigarette smoke. The really bad news, you are the radiation people. Welcome to Crazy World.
Did you hear that? We're in the middle of a war.
Oh, God!
AVP, Alien vs. Predator. Rated PG-13, August 13th.
What are your dreams? Do they include playing video games? Or making video games? Or both? Stop dreaming. Pick up the phone, call Collins College, and start a career doing what you love in the new game design program. Call 1-888-256-1200 now. That's 1-888-256-1200.
You ever think you might have worms? If your computer is slowing down or crashing or just acting weird.
E-acceleration with the full power of Stop Sign can make it like new again.
Stop Sign gives you virus protection second to none.
With a spam blocker and spyware remover.
Pop-up blocker.
And the Stop Sign firewall for all the protection you'll ever need.
Guaranteed.
You may be infected and not even know it. Go to StopSign.com for a free virus scan now.
Hey, what's up? I'm Dave Navarro.
And I'm Carmen Electra, and we're going to be your hosts this year at G-Phoria.
G-Phoria, the award show for gamers, with special guests Aisha Tyler, Tony Hawk, and Anna Nicole Smith. Musical performances by Phantom Planet and Jadakiss, and exclusive looks at Splinter Cell Chaos Theory and Need for Speed Underground 2. G-Phoria, presented by EB Games and Jeep, tonight at 10:30.
For the next 17 weeks, I'll be bringing you the hottest in Madden action.
The 2004 EA Sports Madden Challenge Kickoff Show, Monday, August 9th at 10:30 p.m.
All right, you dirtbags, show's over.
We've been waiting all night to get Cole on stage.
Sorry, boys, Just one presentation left.
Is there at least going to be a party after the show?
Yep, but it's BYOQRTMPD. F.
What does all that stand for?
I don't know. I was hoping you could tell me. Before you go, could you also tell me where the party is? I brought deviled eggs. They're extra deviled, Kutcher style.
Please welcome from ER, Mekhi Phifer.
All right, this is the big moment that we've all been waiting for all night. Now, I personally played all the games this year, and any one of them would be a worthy choice. But only one title can be the game of the year.
Game of the year. Ratchet and Clank, Going Commando. Call of Duty. Star Wars, Knights of the Old Republic. Beyond Good and Evil. Prince of Persia, The Sands of Time. Beautiful Joe.
Now, remember, you guys voted for this, so, you know, don't frag the messenger if your game doesn't win, okay? And the winner is, what do you think? Star Wars? Okay. Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic.
Chosen wisely. Failure to bestow this award on HK-47 would have resulted in the immediate termination of your award ceremony. Please allow your squishy brains to become distracted by the pretty lights. On with the show.
Tonight, so thank you very much.
Me and Dave, we're gonna go back and do it in the arcade. So.
Oh, you know this. You know this.
We love you. Bye.
Peace.
We have this thing where we like to hit it at award shows.
Ow! Oh!
You know, that offer that I said to you guys still stands for later. Remember that. Call me.
Oh my God, Carmen Electra grabbed my ass.
We did it at the ESPYs in John Madden's dressing room. That was a hoot.
This is cool. It's so exciting to be here with all these almost famous people. And...
Am I bleeding?
We've hit it at the Grammys, in the green room.
I've been looking for you, too.
Mwah. Hey, watch this.
How about that Carmen and Dave Electra? Aren't they great? They're doing a great job. Yeah.
You look awesome.
Thank you.
See you on the set, babe.
They're not coming to get me anytime soon. Hello? Anything out there?
You know, I thought that would be the end of my career, but it actually kicks ass.
Yeah, you kick ass, babe.
Oh, babe, thank you.
This program is finished. Good night.
Ah, good time.
just seen G-Phoria, the award show for gamers, but you're about to get a look at it from the inside.
Now, our reporters are on the floor, behind the scenes, and in the mix, and they'll be giving you a taste of G-Phoria you didn't see.
You'll get a wrap-up of the awards and a peek at some of the exclusive titles from this year's event.
And it's all happening right now in the G-Phoria Insider, presented by EB Games and Jeep.
Welcome to G-Phoria Insider, brought to you by EB Games and Jeep. I'm Patrick Clark, and she's Morgan Webb. We're here at the Shrine Expo Center, Los Angeles, where the G-Phoria Awards have just been handed out.
But the party is just getting started, and we've got people everywhere to give you the behind-the-scenes look at the action. Whether you want to get an up-close look at Halo 2 multiplayer action, or a recap of the awards, you have come to the right place.
So let's get things rolling and send it down to Kevin Pereira and Victor Lucas, who are probably sandwiched somewhere between Carmen Electra and Dave Navarro.
All right, thanks, Patrick. You know, we're not exactly rubbing up against Carmen Electra or anything like that.
Yeah, what happened with that?
I don't know. We always get the shaft
where
around
is
here. But
Carmen,
however, we are still surrounded by industry insiders and celebrities. So
absolutely.
It's very cool.
Actually, throughout the night, we're going to be talking to all kinds of industry luminaries.
Right.
But first, we're going to kick it to Adam Sessler, who somehow managed to sneak his way backstage.
He's Splinter Sessler.
Yes.
Well,
he Sam Fisher'd his way in there, didn't he?
Totally.
Yeah.
Thanks, guys. Well, some people came to G4A for the games, some for the celebrities, and others for the food. But I came here to work. And if that means I have to spend my evening talking to beautiful women, well, then so be it.
Hi, my name's Adam. I play games for a living.
Look what they have. There's plates. Cups, foliage, and Casper Van Diem. How are you doing?
I'm doing all right. How are you doing?
I'm doing all right. Would you ever think about doing like a play-by-play or doing a show that was only about the video games and people playing that?
No. That's my entertainment. I want to enjoy that, you know? That and a good porno movie.
Hi.
I was in Vice City last year, and I was also in Tony Hawk. I won an award last year.
See? Look at that. I'm with a famous game character. They're not pretend. You have kind of the cowboy theme, and your theme is more, how would you describe it?
I'm a race car driver.
Of course.
I have three kids, and I'm married, so my game time is limited when I'm at home.
You understand, kids? If you want to have more time to game, don't go, you know, learning about the facts of life or nothing like that.
Exactly.
I just came up with this new skater term. Okay, it's called Tonar for totally gnarly. What do you think?
If you got that G4 kind of vibe to you, you might get lucky.
You know what? There's something else that just occurred to me right now. I have the distinct feeling that in about 3 seconds, the screen's going to go wavy. I'm going to be in bed hugging a pillow.
You know, if you play the Playboy Mansion game, mm-hmm. you might get to hug these.
So as you can see, with all the bling celebrities in booty action, everyone's having a good time. There was that Interplay CEO who did ask if he could borrow $10, but hey, another story, another show. Anyhow, let's go back up to Patrick in the skybox.
Thanks, Adam. This year's G4ia featured 22 awards, and all the winners were chosen by you, the G4 Tech TV community. Throughout tonight's show, we'll show you who won and what they had to say about winning. So let's get things started with a look at the winners for Best Adaptation, Best Cinematic, and Best Easter Egg.
I think the award for best adaptation means a lot to us because at BioWare, we really worry about taking care of properties like Star Wars and LucasArts. We really care about making great games, taking something really valuable like the Star Wars license and adding to it, seeing if we can make it even better. The team working on it is tremendous. I mean, both on the LucasArts side and on the BioWare side, a lot of really dedicated, passionate people that cared a lot about the game worked really hard to make it happen.
Final Fantasy X-2 to begin with is the first direct sequel in our entire series, and I think there was a lot of questions and not necessarily doubt, but a lot of thinking in our fans' heads, you know, how the game was going to come out. But knowing that our strengths are in storytelling and the cinematics and the graphics and sound and music, this is really a great feeling to win Best Cinematics. And at the same time, I feel like X-2 has offered so much more in terms of a variety for the Final Fantasy franchise that this is a great honor to win this award. This is LA, home of the high college, home of the-
We're really excited about this. I mean, the game did just so well, much exceeded our expectations, and to get an award as well is great. Well, he's a character that everybody can identify with. The idea of actually being able to play as a real-life person that everybody has such knowledge of is, you know, is exciting for a lot of people. And so we really asked him originally just to do music and the original songs. He's a gamer, and he was excited about the idea of actually being in the game, so we found a way to make that happen.
Feels good to be the D-O-double-G.
When it comes to creating strange characters in strange worlds, few do it better than the aptly titled Oddworld Inhabitants. And with a mysterious new game on the way, the company is once again creating quite a buzz. Let's take a look at what we can expect from Stranger.
I think you better stay out of my way.
Now that you've seen the trailer, let's throw it down to Victor, who's standing by with Lauren Lanning, the co-founder and president of Oddworld Inhabitants.
Thanks, Morgan. Look who I've got here. I've got Lauren Lanning from Oddworld Inhabitants. How's it going, Lauren?
It's going great, Victor. It's great to see you.
This must be kind of cool for you because you came from Hollywood.
Yeah.
And now, that was about 10 years ago that you started making games. Now look at games infiltrating Hollywood. Is it kind of weirding you out or is it cool?
Well, the truth is, this is what we saw coming. And yet, we saw more opportunity in games 10 years ago. So Sherry McKenna and myself, you know, it took a while to convince her, but I said, this is what it's gonna be. And I was a little bit prophesizing at the time. And here it is, manifesting. I think we can move ahead further in games than we could have in Hollywood. Now we're coming back to Hollywood.
Ain't that the truth? You guys are working on Stranger, and Electronic Arts has picked that up. I have to congratulate you on that. I think that's a great partnership there. Tell us about Stranger. It looks like a complete departure for you guys, different from Abe's and Munch's.
Yeah, it is. We wanted to do some experimentation. We wanted a clean slate to work with. We want far more action. We want a lot more edge. We want to up the intensity level of Oddworld. And so we created Stranger. Been working on it for 2.5 years. Really great crew. A lot of smart people. A lot of passion. And this time, this development's been a pleasure. So,
are we going to see Abe or Munch? Are they going to pop out? You're going to blow their heads off or anything like that in this action-packed thing? Or?
They won't be in this game.
Nope.
They won't be anywhere to be seen. No, this is a fresh new area for Oddworld. But it's on the same planet. So it still retains a lot of the humor sensibilities. But the gameplay is a very new direction for us. But I think people will find a lot of things familiar and a lot of things different. And I think they'll be surprised on a lot of levels.
You know, I can't wait to play it. It's called Stranger. It's coming out next year. Lauren, thank you so much.
You bet. Thank you, Victor.
I got to throw it to Patrick and Morgan. This is Lauren Lanning.
Thanks, Victor. As any Oddworld Inhabitants game has taught us, characters are what drives the story and helps immerse you in their world.
And tonight's winner as your favorite character is a ninja who's got a serious chip on his shoulder. Let's take a look at Ninja Gaiden's Ryu Hayabusa.
Ninjas kick ass. I mean, seriously, like, I mean, everybody loves him. It's part of the, especially for guys, I think it's part of everything we always wanted to be when we were kids. And, you know, you take ninjas and let them throw fireballs and, you know, fight gigantic demons. I mean, how could that not be the coolest thing ever?
I think Ryu kind of made a comeback. I think a lot of people actually forgot about him. People know Ninja Gaiden and they know they were playing as this ninja guy. I don't think they knew the character.
He's not some crazy superhero. He's not some crazy guy with powers. He's just a normal guy, a ninja. Everyone loves ninjas. So he goes on, he kills everybody, and people can relate to that.
If you grew up playing games, you probably knew about Ninja Gaiden, and you played the hell out of it. It was a great game back in the day. I think he kind of personifies this badass ninja character that, you know, there's nothing wrong with that. It's the old school. You run around, you do the combos, you just beat the crap out of everybody. And, you know, what's not to like about that? It's a classic video game hero.
G-Phoria Insider is just getting warmed up. After the break, we'll give you a behind-the-scenes look at all the action before the action as we show you how the Shrine was transformed for G-Phoria.
And we'll also give you a look at what you can expect from Half-Life 2 and Counter-Strike Source when we talk with Valve's Doug Lombardi. That's all coming up right here on G-Phoria Insider, presented by EB Games and Jeep.
Oh, thanks, Marge. Mm-hmm.
Sorry.
There's this guy named Murphy. He's got this law that says whatever can go wrong, will. That's why the trail-rated Jeep Grand Cherokee is tested on Earth's toughest terrain. It's your loophole in Murphy's Law.
Mike, stop!
Trail-rated capability. Only in a Jeep 4x4.
Now you should listen to this, because this concerns you.
In Volume 1, Quentin Tarantino took us right to the edge. In Volume 2...
I am gonna kill Bill.
We're going over it.
I'm sorry, that was rude of me, wasn't it?
Revenge gets twisted.
I have a welcome gift from the management.
Uma Thurman, Kill Bill, Volume 2, only this Tuesday on DVD.
Having a huge back-to-school sale on camera phones.
We're all getting Motorola's with Bluetooth technology.
The Samsung with Zoom.
Wait, I thought we agreed on the LG. No. It downloads games.
The Zoom.
You know what, guys? We don't always have to do everything alike.
Celebrate back-to-school with up to $150 off a super-wide selection of the coolest new camera phones available.
We call it our
Now You Can Tell Us Apart plan.
Great savings on camera phones. Another reason Singular fits you best.
Your reign ends right here.
Yep, tear it up.
Dang!
Oh, see, that's what I'm talking about. Come here, let me show you something. You like these? You feeling them?
Yeah.
Go get me a pair.
The rookie is back. Check out the shoes. The hat's the match. The shirt. It's all good.
Hey, rookie, where are my shoes?
Get the Reebok Classic Clip Groove only at Champ Sports, where sport lives.
Come on, guys.
The next 17 weeks, I'll be bringing you the hottest in Madden action. The 2004 EA Sports Madden Challenge Kickoff Show, Monday, August 9th at 10:30 p.m.
Welcome back to G-Phoria Insider, presented by EB Games and Jeep, where we're giving you a unique look at this year's awards.
You know, Patrick, now you and I get to come here and have all the fun, but for the past week, crews have been here transforming the shrine from an expo hall into what you see tonight.
So let's go down to Kevin, who'll take us behind the scenes for a look at how it all happened.
Thanks, guys. You know, just about a week ago, the Shrine Expo was nothing more than a big empty room, but in the last 7 days or so, our crews have really transformed these four walls into the player's paradise we like to call G-Phoria. Here I am outside of the Shrine Expo Center, where 30,000 square feet of floor space have been transformed into G-Phoria. Let's go inside and meet some of the people involved.
It's overwhelming. Just, you know, 4 days ago, I was in here and it's blank floor with nothing, you know, and now here it's all up and pretty close to camera ready.
We drew maps of the building, hundreds of maps of the building. Literally every cable that you see running on the floor prior to it coming here was drawn out.
You're going to be a very popular slab of tile. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Hey, look.
What we've done this year is we've taken this stage that you see over my shoulder here, and we've packed all of our production value onto the stage. As you know, gamers are used to a lot of stimulation, so the philosophy in the stage is have as many looks as possible so we can shoot in many areas.
We're looking at over 130 moving lights and probably about another 150 to 200 conventional lights. We program the show every step of the way.
So from conception to perfection, really. That's where we come, right?
When G4 contacted me, they wanted, you know, their whole new set for the G4ia look. Last year was very organic. This year is very tech-driven. It sort of looks like an iPod is what I was motivated by. There are hundreds of people whose hands have touched this and who've made it better every time. Just imagine this right here. Tons of music, big lights, booming sound, fans screaming celebrities. It's going to be insane. It's going to be intense. And right now, it looks like there's a lot of work left to do. So if we could get on that, that'd be great. Someone could just, can we get somebody out here to turn something on over there? Anybody?
As you can see, everybody behind the scenes of G-Phoria has been working their asses off for the last week trying to make this show happen. Except for me, of course, because I just came here for the game. So why don't you take it away, Morgan, and I'll let you know how Metroid is, all right?
Thanks, Kevin. Now, so you've already seen who you chose as your favorite character.
But there are a lot more games that were given G-Phoria awards tonight. So let's take a look at our next group of winners.
Voted to be the best RPG award was really a great honor for Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. Again, there are a lot of games this year that were great RPGs they were competing against. And, you know, it's a tradition for us at BioWare to make great RPGs and really push the envelope, and we were really happy how it turned out. We also had great support from LucasArts to do that.
Very exciting. It's sort of the, you know, the culmination of a lot of efforts from our team and our partners. And we really love to see not only one of our products win, but a multiplayer product win in this space.
The fact that it's multiplayer is very exciting to us. The game is real-time multiplayer and really kind of represents a milestone for products like this. It's really a new genre and it's very exciting to be part of it.
We're very honored to have won this award because we put our heart into the work. Our soul and heart and our passion, you know, went into creating this graphics. I think it only proves that people recognize good work. You know, our belief is that video games should always have good graphics, and we feel vindicated.
Well, for Unreal Tournament 2004, to win Best Multiplayer Game is a great honor. We put a lot of work into the game. We think it's a lot of fun, and the gamers, they recognized it. They're playing it, they're buying it, they're loving it, and they voted for it. It means the world to us. I think the sheer amount of variety we managed to pack into Unreal Tournament 2004 attracted gamers. It's like, one minute you're in space, the next minute you're driving the tank, the next minute you're running over somebody in a buggy, or fighting on foot. It's that kind of variety that a gamer in 2004 and beyond is going to look to expect.
We've all had a bad day at work at one time or another, but nobody's worst day at work can compare with one day Gordon Freeman had in 1998. And just when he thought it was safe to go back to the job, along comes Half-Life 2. So let's go to Victor, who's with Valve's Doug Lombardi.
Thanks, Patrick. I am standing here with Doug Lombardi from Valve Software, and we're talking, of course, about Half-Life 2. When's it coming out?
Well, we're in the final days of Half-Life 2. We're planning to finish the game in August and hand over the release candidate to Vivendi Universal, and hopefully we'll see the game on store shelves this fall.
Awesome. Now, listen, I want to ask about the source code theft. There's a lot of talk about that out there. What happened? Was everybody apprehended? Everybody caught on that one?
Yeah, actually, we found out what was happening, I believe it was early October last year, and asked members of the gaming community to help us in any way they can. And actually, arrests were made earlier this summer of the people involved.
So you're telling me that gamers actually helped catch these guys?
Absolutely.
Now, you've been working on this game for a long time. You've seen all of the ins and outs of it. Is it going to have the impact that the first Half-Life game had?
Gosh, I really hope it lives up to people's expectations. We're playing it a lot, and we've spent a lot of time to get it right. We're feeling pretty proud of what's been done.
And you guys aren't just putting Half-Life 2 in the box. You're also shipping it with Counter-Strike Source?
Correct.
Tell us about that.
What you have is, you know, a completely overhauled version of Counter-Strike optimized for the Source engine, so you get physics, the rendering, the shader, the better lighting, etc.
Well, I have a prediction. I predict that next G4ia, it's going to be all about Half-Life 2. Doug, thank you so much, man.
Good to see you, Victor.
Get that game out, all right?
We'll do. Take care.
All right, you too. All right, I'm going to kick it back to Patrick and Morgan.
Thanks, Victor. You know, every console has a cornerstone franchise that helps generate interest and, more importantly, revenue for a company.
Right. Now, franchises are wonderful things, but there's a new kid on the block, and he's beautiful. So let's take a look at this year's best new franchise.
Beautiful Joe is a revolution in bringing back 2D aesthetics to 3D gaming, and
it did it without breaking a sweat. It was incredibly stylized and detailed while retaining like all the 2D elements that made 2D gaming great.
He encompasses all that kind of superhero, successfully superhero character that he is, and that, you know, and he's kind of also got that super deformed look, and he's really, he's cute and cool at the same time, and I think he combines both those things, and he's a very successful character.
Came out of left field, you know, it like evoked everything that people remember about their gaming childhoods or their gaming youth, but brought it to a whole new level.
A lot of people notice it because of the style and because the gameplay was so old school. It's this great side-scrolling action fighting game, and the special moves he's got, man, those are cool. Slowing down time, speeding up time, and just like the zoom-in special moves, just beautiful.
We've got much more to come on G-Phoria Insider. After the break, we sent Adam Sessler on a mission to hell, and he'll give us a full report on what his Doom 3 experience was like.
And we'll also get an up-close look at the man behind the snake, Hideo Kojima, as the mastermind of the Metal Gear Solid series receives a special award.
That's all coming up right here on G-Phoria Insider, presented by EB Games and Jeep.
I'm from Kelso, Washington.
Wow, 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 wind of fresh gum, wow, icy cool breath.
Winter Fresh Network, where icy cool breath is always on.
What was that thing?
We're in the middle of a war.
EVP, Alien vs. Predator, rated PG-13, August 13th.
Only at Champ Sports, where sport lives.
When you scan me, what do you see? Just another futureless pot-smoking teenager? Like you can just look at me and know what I am, what I'm worth? Well, you're wrong. I'm an artist. I'm a therapist. And the last time I took a hit, I was kickboxing. Drugs aren't me. My life is my decision. I am my anti-drug.
Break out of the ordinary into a crispity, crunchy, peanut buttery Butterfinger from Nestle.
So I go to Singular for a prepaid phone, and the sales guy hands me this phone with a color screen. And I was like, get out. And he says, yeah, and I can get the latest ringtones and games. And I was like, get out. Then he threw in unlimited weekend minutes, and I was like, get out, get out, get out. And then I got out of there before he changed his mind.
Singular announces a new way to pay as you go. Get features you want, great phone deals, and unlimited weekend calling.
I call it my this phone is loaded plan.
Cool phones on prepaid. Another reason Singular fits you best.
Dry. Air It is unsurpassed. It helps stop wetness so odor can't start.
Air It keeps you dry.
If you want to make tons of money on the internet, then you need a powerful website.
Get your very own free website now that features over 50 ebooks ready to sell like hotcakes. Go to freebookwebsite.com now and instantly start selling the hottest ebooks like No Money Down Real Estate, Making Money on eBay, Golf, Internet Wealth, and many more. Over 200 million people online and $47 billion spent last year alone. Cash in on the high-profit electronic book explosion right now. Go to freebookwebsite.com and sign up free in total privacy. Guaranteed. No monthly cost ever. Get your free website instantly, right now. No waiting. It's all 100% totally automatic. There's no inventory to buy, no selling, no order taking, no customer service, no shipping, and no hidden costs. Go to freebookwebsite.com. We call it a cash machine on autopilot. But hurry before it's too late.
Whether you're playing for bragging rights or making a run at 50 grand in Vegas, prepare for the hardest-hitting video game tournament in America with the 2004 EA Sports Madden Challenge Kickoff Show with tips from Madden experts.
Pick the team that's right for you.
If you catch the person at the right time, that could be a real punishing shot.
Advice from tournament veterans.
You gotta keep everybody off balance.
And a look at the kings of the controller.
I'm gonna shock some people tonight.
The 2004 EA Sports Madden Challenge Kickoff Show. Tune in Monday at 10:30 p.m.
Welcome back to G-Phoria Insider, brought to you by EB Games and Jeep. I'm Patrick Clark here with Morgan Webb in the skybox high above the action.
You may have seen the awards show already, but we're giving you a unique perspective of G-Phoria from both behind the scenes and in the middle of the action.
But before we get back to the party, let's hear from more of tonight's winners.
Tony Hawk franchise is known for having amazing soundtracks, and we always just try to get an eclectic group of bands in, old, new, rock, punk, rap. You don't get tired of it as easily when you've got such a variety. We've always had amazing soundtracks for our extreme sports titles, so it's good to win.
It feels great when any team works hard. You really want fans and players to like it, so when they vote for it, it's awesome. I think the game is a successor too for us because, first off, it's got a great gameplay. So we didn't rest on the license. EA always focuses on gameplay as the most important factor, and then it was also helped, of course, because Lord of the Rings. Everybody loves that.
I think the EB Games Award was a great award for Knights of the Old Republic to win. It's such an honor to be recognized by such a preeminent franchise of gaming. EB is well known as a company that supports gaming, and to win their award means great things. We're really pleased about that.
To make Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic be, you know, really loved by the fans, again, it's delivering on a Star Wars experience. I mean, just from, you know, the voice acting of the game, the music, cinematics, and really pulling that story together, those things really resonate with the fans, and they wanted that Star Wars experience.
It's been on pretty much hiatus for Final Fantasy to be available on the handheld, so to win this award means a lot. Final Fantasy in recent years have only been released on the console, so to know that we have fans also on the handheld market is a great feeling.
For more than a decade, id Software has constantly raised the bar for 3D action games, and their newest creation, Doom 3, is no exception. Let's go to Adam, who's standing by at the Doom 3 pod.
Oh, that's right, Morgan. John Carmack and all those other smart people that work at id, they pretty much spent 4 years putting together a game engine that's designed to make me poop myself with terror. So we're standing outside of the Doom 3 pod right now. I'm heading in to check it out. To get some better insight on why this game makes me soil myself, we have Marty Stratton from id. So in making a game that is scary, what were you trying to go for first?
Well, you know, the artists and the designers have a lot of influences. We look at terrifying movies, a lot of scary games, and just pull it all together into a game that we love to play and that scares us.
Ah, oh, don't reload the shoot. Oh, ah, oh.
We've really exceeded our expectations. I mean, we all had really high hopes. You talk to anybody at id, you ask them what's the best game id's ever made, and it's Doom 3.
Well, he's hurting me.
Yeah, this is intense. I'm gonna weep for a little bit, so let's throw it back to you, Patrick.
All right, well, Kevin's got something interesting from the floor, so Kevin, take it away.
G-Phoria is the video game event of the century, and you can't pre-order your way in here, but here's an EB Games fan who made it here. David, how did this all come about?
I don't know. I was just at the mall, and I was entering. My girlfriend didn't want me to because she told me I'd have no chance of winning, but I won anyway, so, yeah.
So now you're a guy with a girlfriend, and you're in EB Games. How does that work?
I don't know. She actually likes video games. She forced me to try out Final Fantasy X, actually.
Nice. And was it right for you?
Yeah, I haven't finished it yet, but I will.
And how's the party been so far? Are you enjoying yourself tonight?
Yeah, it's been really great. My friend got a hug from Anna Nicole Smith, and he's been talking about it all night.
And there's a lot of guys who got a lot more from Anna Nicole Smith tonight.
Yeah, I know.
The Jeep Legend Award was created to recognize the pioneers of the video game industry. This year's winner, Metal Gear creator Hideo Kojima, definitely fits that bill. So let's go down to Vigor, who's with him right now.
Thanks, Patrick. I'm standing here with Mr. Hideo Kojima, and I have to say, congratulations on winning the Jeep Legend Award. That's a very big honor. How does that feel?
I'm still very excited. I'm really, really happy.
All right, listen, we all want to know about Metal Gear Solid. What was the inspiration for Solid Snake? Where did you come up with that character?
Since Solid Snake is a character that the player controls, I tried to make him as colorless as possible because I didn't want his personalities to interfere with the personalities of the players. And I think making him colorless is what appealed to the player.
Now, with Snake Eater, is this going to be the end of your Solid Snake stories? Or is this the last Metal Gear we're going to be playing?
It'll probably be the last Metal Gear Solid that myself, Hideo Kojima, would work on as a director, script writer, and game designer. But as long as people desire more Metal Gear Solid games, I'll probably work as a producer to come up with more Metal Gear Solid games. But it could be the last Metal Gear Solid that I put together myself.
Well, thanks a lot, guys. I cannot wait to play Snake Eater. Thank you very much. And it's back to you guys.
Thanks, Vic. And there's no question that Kojima truly is a legend. After all, who could create a sexist, chain-smoking, mullet-wearing super spy that people actually like?
But what is it exactly that makes Kojima and Solid Snake legendary? Well, we talked to some of tonight's attendees to find out.
What Hideo Kojima has done for the industry is that he's really brought in a film and a cinematic element to video games.
One of the things that sets him apart from a lot of other developers is that he really pushes the envelope. Every game he does is something new and something innovative, and he's going in his own direction. He's not following, he's leading. I think that makes him an extremely unique developer.
His sense of irony about games and his sense that gaming exists in a cultural landscape versus simply, you know, in its own circle is unparalleled. Kojima has a sense of pacing and timing and style that the rest of the industry could learn a lot from.
He just made an unbelievable franchise that spanned so many years, and it was a franchise that always grew and introduced new things, and the polish, the production values, and the immersion, not many people could pull off what he was able to pull off.
What's really exciting about Metal Gear is they found a way to blend action that's appealing to the West and drama that's appealing to the East and bring the two of them together in a way that both our audiences appreciate.
He keeps pioneering, and he kind of keeps taking the genre farther and farther, and that's what I think really sets him apart from some of the other designers out there.
Our coverage from this year's G-Phoria is far from over. After the break, it's been in development for what seems like a decade. But is Psychonauts finally on its way to the Xbox? Well, we'll talk to the game's designer to find out.
And we'll also give you an exclusive first look at Sam Fisher's next assignment, Splinter Cell Chaos Theory. That's all coming up right here on G-Phoria Insider, presented by EB Games and Jeep.
Do it.
Introducing the new Jeep Wrangler Unlimited with a Sunrider soft top. With more passenger room and twice the cargo space, you'll be able to bring so much stuff that you're bound to forget something.
Hey, what's up?
Got everything, right?
Yeah, we got everything.
Why?
Thanks. Trail-rated capability, only in a Jeep 4x4.
Save on all your favorite music this week at Circuit City. All CDs are on sale for just $11.99 or less all week long. So now's the best time to save on rock, R&B, rap, and country. From today's biggest artists like Brandy, Velvet Revolver, The Beastie Boys, Jadakiss, and more. You'll find thousands of titles to choose from, so hurry in and save today. All CDs are on sale for just $11.99 or less this week only at Circuit City.
We'll be right back.
hell on you. What's up?
Accelerate your life. On DVD this Tuesday.
I've killed a hell of a lot of people to get to this point.
The bride is back and has taken a solemn vow.
I am gonna kill Phil.
Only this Tuesday on DVD.
You know that buddy list you love? Now you can take it with you on your Singular phone. Because no one makes it easier to use mobile instant messaging than Singular. Your buddy list goes with you everywhere. And right now, get unlimited instant messaging for $2.99 and a great deal on I Am Ready Nokia phones.
I call it my buddy list goes with me plan.
AOL Instant Messenger, another reason Singular fits you best.
Late night. Hold on tight.
Get a load of this.
At 11, go crazy with Video Game Mania on X-Play.
The biggest video game event in the world.
Then take a walk on the wild side of technology on Unscrewed with Martin Sargent.
I'm Martin Sargent, and I like to ramble. That was fantastic.
It's back-to-back action. Weeknights. X-Play at 11 and Unscrewed at 11:30. Only on G4 Tech TV.
Welcome back to G-Phoria Insider, presented by EB Games and Jeep. I'm Morgan Webb, and alongside Patrick Clark, we're giving you a look at tonight's event from a unique perspective.
We've got all of tonight's winners, along with exclusive looks at some upcoming games. So right now, let's take a look at a never-before-seen trailer for Tim Schafer's Psychonauts.
At a unique summer camp for the paranormally gifted, young cadets perfect their powers.
Don't you train Psychonauts here?
And the counselors have secrets to hide.
We're gonna have to remove your brain and make it shoot down innocent civilians with its psychic death beam.
A deranged man is building an army to take over the world.
Oh my God! Let's make out!
Now he must fight like a warrior and stop an evil genius from leaving the world brainless. Get ready for the one game that goes mental.
You will find yourselves on the path to becoming international secret agents. In other words, Psychonauts!
Microsoft first showed Psychonauts behind closed doors at E3 in 2002. But 2 years later, Psychonauts finds itself in development purgatory, still searching for a publisher. Now that hasn't stopped the game's designer, Tim Schafer, from working on his masterpiece. And he's standing by with Victor right now.
Thanks, Morgan. You guys look like you're having too much fun up there. You better calm down a little bit. I'm standing here with Tim Schafer, who runs Double Fine Studios. These guys are making Psychonauts. And originally it was being published by Microsoft, but that's not happening now. What happened there?
As of pretty recently, we just started a new relationship with Majesco. I don't know if you know about that.
Cool.
It's not quite announced yet.
So we just got a G4ia exclusive right here, didn't we? It's coming out from Majesco.
I should really check on that. Yeah, I know. Yes, that is yes.
Beautiful. You're among friends and family here. It's all good, man. It's all good. Now, for the people out there that don't know what Psychonauts is all about, can you give us a nutshell kind of description of what it is?
Yeah, Psychonauts is about a young psychic who has the ability to jump into people's minds. He doesn't just read people's minds, but he jumps into their imaginary worlds and runs around. So the levels of the game are just these crazy mental worlds of these crazy characters you meet.
Now, Psychonauts is a very out there kind of concept. How did it come to you? Were you at you have somebody in a hospital that you know and they told you some stories, or what happened?
Well, I always liked how in video games you can do anything, right? Like in a Mario game, you can have a bullet with a face on it and it doesn't completely abstract and surreal. So when you're in someone's head and you see some crazy monster and then you come out of their head, and you realize that's something going on inside someone's brain,
yeah,
all of a sudden it gives the game kind of an emotional depth and a weight to it that hopefully will be more intriguing and put you deeper into the story and into the characters.
All right, Tim, when is Psychonauts coming out? When are we going to be able to play this game?
Early in 05.
Early in 05. How early? Like January 1?
Crack of dawn.
Crack of dawn.
Early, yeah.
On the first day. Cannot wait. Thank you, Tim.
Thank
now
you.
I got to throw it back to Patrick. Hope you guys are having fun up there.
Thanks, Vic. If and when Psychonauts is released, I'm pretty sure Tim Schafer will be here accepting his own award. But there are still awards from this year's G-Phoria that you haven't seen. So let's take a look at our next group of winners.
Who are you?
Bond. James Bond.
Oh, it's exciting. It's really great. It's an honor. I'm terribly thrilled. I mean, this game was a huge effort, and we're really proud of it, and we're really happy that people were excited about it as we are. And I mean, a lot of people said the game feels like an interactive movie, and that's what we were setting out to make, right? And it felt like it, right? I mean, when Pierce Brosnan comes down and starts talking like James Bond, well, you start feeling like James Bond, and that's really what we're shooting for.
Oh, grow up, 007.
The Matrix is like a really special kind of case because everyone involved with it is a AAA actor, you know, Hollywood star. So what she brings to that is that the Hollywood feel, that Hollywood talent that you expect to see out of a movie, you know? So people see the game, they're like, oh, you know what? This is a cinematic experience just as much as any movie is.
Jada Pinkett Smith brought character to enter The Matrix, and I think that's something that maybe it lacked. She brought some sort of real human character to it.
I would say equally, you know, me personally, Riku, Yuna, and Pain, all three girls in Final Fantasy tend to look hot and they look sexy. But I think it's just her personality and the role that she played in the game was not only hot, but really cute, and it brings out her personality. I think Tara Strong did a really great job voicing the character. I'm just happy that she won the hottest character. You know, our gamers, I think a lot of our fans get so attached to a character in a certain Final Fantasy game that to sort of keep her going, in this case, you know, from Final Fantasy 10 to Final Fantasy 10-2. I think that it had a lot of curiosity. You wanted to really see what Riku was going to do next.
Sometimes we want more than just eye candy. Sometimes we want something new and fresh. Sort of like the multiplayer experience of Splinter Cell Pandora Tomorrow, which is this year's winner for Best Innovation.
The important thing about innovation in video games is that you create a benchmark. And when you create that benchmark, that becomes the game to beat. And it raises the entire industry and all of games to a higher level. So that's why I think innovation is a very, very important category.
Splinter Cell took a different approach. Their multiplayer, it seems so simple, you know, when you first think about it, but it's ingenious, it's brilliant. Like, this first person with third person, it's so natural.
I think people automatically assumed if you had a third-person game, kind of a stealth action game, you couldn't do multiplayer, because multiplayer traditionally was all about versus lots of shooting, and now here comes this game where you have stealth versus first-person shooting. I think a lot of people have to go back to the drawing board and just say, hey, wait a second, this game I thought I couldn't make in a multiplayer mode, I can do it now.
First introduced to Sam Fisher in 2002, most people were impressed by his arsenal of weapons and gadgets. And then, of course, there was the split jump, which led to many a groin pull among Fisher wannabes. Now he's back for his third tour of duty, and here's Kevin with a closer look.
That's right, Patrick. You know, Sam Fisher has become somewhat of a cult hero ever since he first appeared on the Xbox, and now he's up for his third assignment in only 2 years, and I got a chance to get a little pre-mission briefing on Splinter Cell Chaos Theory. All right, so Sam Fisher is definitely back in action, and I'm here with Xavier. Can you tell me, what's the guy up to this time?
Well, Sam Fisher is back, as you just said, and you know he's gonna get a lot of new cool moves, and he's gonna have new weapons, but the most important of all is that it's really gonna be a totally new experience.
All right, so you just said something really important there. I love the online component of the last Splinter Cell, but the one thing that I was missing was that co-op aspect when it came to taking down the bad guys. So tell us about co-op and Chaos.
Well, the cooperative mode in Chaos Theory is totally different from what you experience in Pandora Tomorrow. You're gonna be two spies working together within missions that are actually linked to the single player in terms of storyline, and you play against NPCs, computer. So you don't play against real players.
Now right now, our viewers at home are actually seeing exclusive footage of Chaos Theory. I mean, can you describe what they're looking at?
Well, the graphics are simply amazing. The first game was really recognized as being some of the best lighting effects in video games. This time the lighting effects are even better, but also the textures are a lot better. We introduced the bump mapping in the franchise, which makes everything really realistic.
Can you give us the platforms and the expected release date?
Well, right now, the platform that are announced with release dates are PC and Xbox for Christmas.
There's still more to come. After the break, we'll talk to some of the industry's biggest names and get their thoughts on how things have changed since last year's G-Phoria.
And Kevin and Adam will give you a glimpse of what to expect with Halo 2's multiplayer. It's all coming up right here on G-Phoria Insider, brought to you by EB Games and Jeep.
Jeep Liberty. With its Command Track four-wheel drive and dynamic suspension system, it'll get you out of the most impossible situations. Trail-rated capability. Only in a Jeep 4x4.
Your reign ends right here.
Yep, tear it up.
Dang!
Oh, see, that's what I'm talking about. Come here, let me show you something. You like these? You feeling them?
Yeah.
Go get me a pair.
The rookie is back. Check out the shoes. The hat, the match, the shirt. It's all good.
Hey, rookie, where are my shoes?
Get the Reebok Classic Clip Groove only at Champ Sports, where sport lives.
Come on, guys.
Ladies and gentlemen, Kyle Parker Manipulator. Did you know tobacco companies add ammonia to cigarettes? Ammonia boosts the impact of nicotine on the brain.
This summer, in these woods, there's Bath.
You can't outrun that bear.
I don't have to outrun the bear. I just have to outrun you.
There's Ugly.
Hey, guy, you need to use your phone.
Yo, no! And there's just plain wrong.
Mmm, bacon.
Squirrel.
Mmm, squirrel.
Without a paddle.
Help, man! There's a grenade up here!
No! Rated PG-13. Starts Wednesday, August 18th, only in theaters.
You love? Now you can take it with you on your Singular phone. Because no one makes it easier to use mobile instant messaging than Singular. Your buddy list goes with you everywhere. And right now, get unlimited instant messaging for $2.99 and a great deal on I Am Ready Nokia phones.
I call it my buddy list goes with me plan.
AOL Instant Messenger, another reason Singular fits you best.
Check this out. This is what we do for a living.
We're video game designers.
And we're game programmers.
With the training offered at Collins College, you can learn to design, code, and test games like this.
And this.
Game design is a growing career.
For a brochure on a career in game design, call Collins College at 1-888-256-1200 now. That's 1-888-256-1200. Call Collins College now.
You ever think you might have worms? If your computer is slowing down or crashing or just acting weird,
e-acceleration with the full power of StopSign can make it like new again.
StopSign gives you virus protection second to none.
With a spam blocker and spyware remover,
pop-up blocker,
and the StopSign firewall for all the protection you'll ever need.
Guaranteed.
You may be infected and not even know it. Go to StopSign.com for a free virus scan now.
Whether you're playing for bragging rights or making a run at 50 grand in Vegas, prepare for the hardest-hitting video game tournament in America with the 2004 EA Sports Madden Challenge Kickoff Show, with tips from Madden experts.
Pick the team that's right for you.
If you catch the person at the right time, that could be a real punishing shot.
Advice from tournament veterans.
You gotta keep everybody off balance.
And a look at the kings of the controller.
I'm gonna shock some people tonight.
The 2004 EA Sports Madden Challenge Kickoff Show. Tune in Monday at 10:30 p.m.
Welcome back to G4A Insider, presented by EB Games and G. I'm Patrick Clark, alongside Morgan Webb. We're giving you a look at this year's event from the inside.
G4A is one of those rare occasions when you get some of the top names in the industry under one roof at the same time. Let's go down to Victor, who had a chance to catch up with a few of them.
Thanks, guys. As you can probably tell from the success of G4A here tonight, the video game industry is more popular than it's ever been. As a matter of fact, I managed to sneak out there and talk to some of our guests here tonight about where the video game industry is now and where it's headed to in the future. Take a look.
The most important trend in gaming right now is understanding the impact of the next generation consoles, you know, the tremendous power that they're going to bring to bear. We're going to have to become much, much closer with Hollywood and bring some of the best talent, some of the best direction that we can get from that market, bring it together with what we're currently doing in gaming. Over the next 4 or 5 years, we're going to see, a real revolution in the way that we build games, and I don't even know what that's going to look like at the end.
Graphics are getting to a point where you're not going to impress people as much as you did in the past. It's going to have to be content, and that means innovation, that means incredible licenses, and that means something very unique that brings the player into your game. So I think more than ever, you're going to see a competition for quality.
When we go into the next generation of consoles, you know, how many small developing companies are going to be able to hack it? I mean, it's going to become more and more expensive to make video games, and some of these smaller developers, design boutique developers, they're going to have a tough time reaching budgets to create these next generation games. And, you know, companies like EA and the larger companies, they'll have no problem, but you know what's going to happen to the smaller guys? You know, there might be a little bit of a shakedown.
There are a lot of issues facing the game industry today. Games are becoming more expensive. They're taking longer to make. Getting a profit out of any game is becoming harder and harder. The hits make it. Anything that isn't a hit fails, and it's becoming harder and harder to attract the attention of the gamer.
I think the great games sell. No matter how much marketing goes into it, you're not going to push a bad game, and there's always that opportunity for the title to break out.
This season's so crowded with such huge sequels, and there's so much good product coming out there, you just can't get attention as a small developer introducing a new original franchise. A lot of original franchises that were slated for this fall are now being pushed out till next year to give them a fighting chance.
It becomes harder and harder to rise to the surface in the game industry. This year, more than any other year, if you're not absolutely at the top of the heap, nobody knows you're coming.
Well, that's it for me from G4A. I had a fantastic time. Let's go back to Patrick and Morgan in the skybox.
Thanks, Victor. Now, it used to be that if you wanted to play a sports game, your choices were pretty limited. But that all changed a few years ago when a guy named Hawk McTwisted onto the scene. So now we've got winners for both traditional sports and alternative sports, along with the winner for best racing game.
You know, the team, they wish they could be here to accept this. I mean, the team just put so much effort and work into the title that to be recognized by G4 and the G4 viewers is such an incredible honor. It was something that people could really click with. I mean, the tuner cars, how you can upgrade your cars, you know, just the street driving, the nighttime, you know, it was something that people could relate to.
It's awesome. Neversoft really makes the game for their fans, and they always pay attention to feedback year after year, and they want to make the best possible game every year. So, you know, they try to cram as much good stuff in every time. We definitely just took it in a new direction for the franchise and added in the story mode, and it's the most customizable video game ever, which is probably why it won, because dropping your face into the game and making yourself the main character, what kid wouldn't want that?
It's a huge honor for Madden NFL franchise. I mean, every year the guys at the EA Tiburon studio, I mean, they all just work their heads off to make the best game to come out. And so to do it year after year, it's just a great accomplishment. We're just glad that the fans were digging it. I mean, I think the real innovations in the 2004 product were the playmaker control, so just all new gameplay control. And then people were just blown away by owner mode, being able to set your ticket prices, setting the price of your cheese curds in Green Bay. It's just unbelievable depth.
Morgan, you know, while you and I have been here holding down the fort all night long, Kevin and Adam have been doing their own thing.
You know, from what I've heard, they've developed quite an intense rivalry in Halo 2. So let's check in with them and see if they can work things out.
Thanks, guys, and yes, it's very true. Adam and I could not settle who's pacier. We've been arguing for hours, so we decided it's coming down to a Halo 2 match.
And, you know, like real men, we can't do it for fun. So there's a wager involved, and there's quite a bit at stake.
Yeah, we'll find out about all that later, but right now, let's get to the Halo 2 match.
Yes, let's do that. I'm gonna try and make you lose.
X-Play, more like X-Lame.
Oh yeah, right. Kinda like, hey, I'm Kevin, I've hosted more shows than I've had women.
I have, actually.
Oh, whoa. Oh yeah.
It's too easy, I don't even need to touch it. I don't even need to touch it. Are you still talking? Because I'm busy killing you. Hold on a second.
Oh,
oh, I'm so good.
Who's got the flag, Sessler?
That's me with your flag. That right there? No. It's all right. I know where I'm going.
You can't see.
I don't even need to see. I ain't looking. 3, 2, 1. That's game, ladies and gentlemen. That's game, Sessler.
Are we really serious about that whole, like, wager thing? I mean, that was just kind of a joke, right? PSP is gonna own you.
That's cool. I think the bargain called for the loser to shout that, though, at the Nintendo booth, so let's hear it.
PSP is gonna own you! Oh, no! Oh, why do I ever leave the fetal position?
Oh, I love Nintendo fanboys. Oh, this is my victory sandwich, Sessler. It tastes so good. Come on, have a bite. Have a bite of victory. Oh, you wish you could taste victory, don't you? Back to you, Morgan.
Yeah, Adam always loses.
You know, this entire evening culminated with one moment, the award for Game of the Year. There were 6 very worthy nominees, but in the end, the choice was clear.
Because when you take the Star Wars universe and turn it into an amazing RPG, you created something huge, which is exactly what BioWare did with Knights of the Old Republic.
Knights of the Old Republic deserves the award because RPGs and role-playing games have always kind of been seen as the territory of the Japanese. And finally, you know, a Western developer creates a very excellent RPG. And I think for that reason alone, it deserves that award.
Lots of games set out to reach heights. KOTOR was one of those games that didn't skimp in any area. KOTOR is one of those games that delivered your expectations.
KOTOR has this grand storyline and these amazing characters, and then it wraps it all into this beautiful Star Wars package. Once you start building your own lightsaber, that's it, man. You're not gonna stop playing.
With BioWare, you're dealing with people who deal with like an RPG world, and they're really comfortable with dealing with a hardcore Dungeons & Dragons style role-playing player. And so they were able to like connect with these sort of hardcore gamers and yet bring in a world of casual people who just love the Star Wars universe.
Everyone loves Star Wars, and unfortunately, you know, there haven't been that many good Star Wars games. Knights of the Old Republic really took that universe and made it real. Do you want to be evil? Do you want to be good? And you have that choice. This is the first game to actually realize that universe and let the player do what they want to do. And every aspect, you know, was successful.
So that just about does it for G-Phoria Insider. It's been another great year for the industry, and there's no better time to be a gamer.
Now, whether it's the roster of next-generation consoles and handhelds coming in the near future, or the killer list of new games on the way, I have to say you're absolutely right, Patrick.
Well, thank you.
But you know what? Let's wrap this up so I can go show Kevin how it's really done in Halo 2.
All right, then. For Morgan Webb, I'm Patrick Clark, and we'll see you at next year's G-Phoria.